Thank you very much, Chairwoman Blackburn and Ranking Member Schakowsky, members of the committee. I very much appreciate the opportunity to appear before you this morning, but I do so with great concern. I know you will hear from my colleague, Senator Sass from Nebraska, and I respect his deeply held personal beliefs. But if we want to have a civil discussion on this issue, we should begin with the facts. Already news articles today have called into question the validity of the exhibits that will be presented to the panel. This committee's very existence was founded on the basis of highly deceptive, edited videos. These videos have since been proven to be misleading and false by multiple independent investigations across the country. In January, after thorough investigations into the videos, a Texas grand jury cleared Planned Parenthood of any wrongdoing and indicted the individuals responsible for their creation. In fact, 12 other states have also cleared Planned Parenthood of any wrongdoing, and 8 additional states have declined to investigate, citing a lack of evidence. I believe it's now time for the special investigations to end. And I'd also like to point out that fetal tissue research has long had bipartisan support. In 1993, Congress passed the National Institutes of Health Revitalization Act, which permits fetal tissue research. That bill passed with overwhelmingly support, 94-4 in the Senate and 290-130 in the House. And I think it's important to note that that bill was passed on recommendations of a blue ribbon panel convened under President Reagan, which was tasked with studying the ethics of fetal tissue research. Millions of people have benefited from fetal tissue research. Vaccines for polio and rubella were developed as a result of research done on fetal tissue. And research on health issues that touch so many of us, Parkinson's disease, diabetes, HIV/AIDS, eye disorders, and spinal cord injuries have also benefited from the 1993 law. If it's the panel's desire to change the law, obviously you as legislators are able to do that. But I believe it would be a grave error. Sadly, it's my belief that this panel was formed with political motivations. There is very little real interest in an unbiased investigation to uncover facts related to women's health or research. Instead, I believe that this panel serves as an opportunity for some to once again attack the healthcare providers whom millions of women and families depend on. In February, I joined with colleagues in both chambers to ask House and Senate leadership to disband this panel and all other congressional investigations that would undermine women's access to healthcare. Not only do I believe that this panel is an inappropriate and wasteful misuse of federal resources, but I'm gravely concerned that it also puts researchers, providers, and patients across the country at risk. Unfortunately, as a result of the political rhetoric surrounding this issue, we've seen violent acts and threats against women health providers and researchers across the country. And I'm very sad to report that this fall, the same month that this panel was formed, a women's health clinic in Claremont, New Hampshire, was vandalized not once, but twice. The second attack caused so much damage that the clinic was forced to close for nearly 6 weeks, and this was a real disservice to the women, men, and families who rely on the full range of services that the clinic provides. And unfortunately, New Hampshire's not alone. After the release of the deceptive, highly edited videos, incidents of harassment against some health centers increased ninefold in just 1 month. I don't believe that today's hearing is a fact-based, objective investigation, but rather it is a taxpayer-funded political attack based on discredited evidence. I hope it will finally be time to move on. And Madam Chair, if I could apologize for the need to leave early and go back to a hearing, I appreciate, again, the opportunity to be here. Thank you.